Praise the Lord. It's time to begin our service this morning.
Yeah.
Are you all excited to be here this morning?
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
You're excited? Let's all stand. Let's go before our God in prayer this morning. Continue to lift him up, not only in this sanctuary, but in our bodies and sanctuary this morning. Heavenly Father, we lift up your holy name in this place this morning, God. Lord, give you all the glory, the praise that's due you. This is the day that the Lord has made. God, Lord, let's rejoice in it, God. Let's be glad in it this morning, Lord. Help us, Lord, this morning, God, to get out of ourselves, to throw ourselves aside, throw the pride aside, and lift up our hearts unto you this morning. Thank you this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. Go to worship God this morning, saints. Hallelujah. That's what you came here to do this morning, to worship his holy name this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, God, for this opportunity once again, Lord, to be in your presence this morning. Praise God. Come on, brother. Let's do some songs this morning.
Amen. If you may say, let's turn to page 89 and sing that name song, Glory to His Name. Page 89.
Ourselves before you this morning. God, that your spirit will rest upon each one of us this morning. Thank you this morning, Lord. for your love and your concern for each one of us this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. You may be seated this morning. Amen. I don't know what you came here to do. I ain't come here to go to sleep this morning.
Amen.
Amen. So you here when you fall asleep, whatever it's not, you say, well, preacher, if I leave, then I won't be in church. Well, you ain't in church if you're falling asleep.
Amen.
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 Amen. The Lord, he desires your worship.
That's right.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Your praise.
That's right.
Amen. Say with that, all men lift up holy hands without wrath or doubting.
That's right.
It's up to you.
Amen.
Up to you. It ain't the pastor. It ain't the piano player.
Yes.
It ain't Sister Wall singing.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, you change. Well, wife can't sing. It ain't the singing.
Amen.
It's not even the church. It's you.
That's right.
It's you. You have to lift up.
That's right.
The precious name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Amen. It's good to be back in God's house tonight.
Amen.
Oh, this morning. Say, man, preach, you don't know what day it is? Is it night or the morning? Hey, we're here all the time. Amen. Amen. If you only here on Sunday morning, well, that's your choice. And we're going to be sharing about that this morning. But it's up to you. It's up to you. It's your choice. It's your choice of how much the Lord or God that you want. It's your choice. Not anyone else's. Not anyone else. Not the pastor. Not the church. Can't blame anybody else for the things that's going on in your life. Hello?
Amen.
Anyway, I'm not preaching right now, but I will be preaching in a few minutes. Amen.
Amen.
But it's good to be back in God's house this morning. Looking forward to all that God has for each one of us on this morning. He has a lot in store for us.
Amen.
But it's up to us to receive it.
That's right.
It's up to us to grasp hold of all that the Lord has for us so that we can apply it to our hearts and our lives.
Yeah.
God has so much in store for us, but it's up to us to apply it to our lives. You know, it's like a treasure chest that's opened.
Right.
We can look inside and peer inside and see everything that's inside of it. But if we don't grasp hold of the things that's in there, then it's just sin. It's just there for looks.
Amen.
So it's up to you to grasp hold of the treasures that God has for you. You know, I just think in your mind's eye, you're grasping hold of those, the jewels and everything that's in God's treasure chest, and it's just flowing through your fingers or whatever. You'll be like, oh, I can feel it. Yes, I can.
Yes.
Like Michael Jackson said, can you feel it?
Yes.
Yeah, I can feel it this morning. I'm thankful that the Lord is real.
Amen.
It's real. It's more than just osmosis. It's more than just think positive thinking. But it's applying the word of God to your life, believing the words of the word of God as truth.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Don't forget our service times. Tonight we do have a 6:30 evening service tonight here at the church Sunday night. Also Tuesday we teaching Bible study there Tuesday at 6:30. Somebody just called me this morning and said, "Hey preacher, could you come pick me up a bike? I need a ride."
Amen.
I said, "Well, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God." So we'll work it out for you, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a lot other for that conversation. But anyway, Thursday, midweek service, 6:30. Also, Saturday, we're here on prayer meeting, 12 o'clock. Come. Who are you praying for, preacher? We're praying for you.
Amen.
So come. Help us pray for each other.
Amen.
Amen. Pray for yourself. Pray for us. Pray for those that the Lord has dealt with your heart about. Come and pray. Come to prayer meeting on Saturday morning at noon. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Well, preacher, I ain't even out of bed at noon. Well, you need to get out of bed before noon. Anyway.
Yes.
Right back here Sunday morning at 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
Amen. This time, we're going to receive our offering and tithe as your brother Josh will come and help us. You give us unto the Lord, and the Lord will richly bless you. And all Christians do pay tithe.
Amen. Yes, sir.
It's quiet out there. You know, people don't pay tithe. They... They don't say nothing. But the people that do give, hey, amen, praise God. Amen. All Christians pay tithe.
Praise the Lord.
And cheerfully.
Amen.
It is. That was one. And cheerfully giving offerings this morning. Give as unto the Lord, and the Lord will richly bless you. This man, I'll share it afterwards. Go ahead, pray.
Yes, sir. Our loving Father, we thank you for this opportunity to be able to give you this Sunday morning. God, we just ask that you would now bless the gift and the giver. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Thank you for your giving. The Lord will richly bless you. This gentleman, he called me this morning and was asking about the service times and wanted to come out to church. And I said, we can work out a ride for you, sir, if you need to come out. You know, we'll get somebody to come and get you. And he said, I need to come to church and I need to pay my tithe. And I said, sir, I said, it's good and all. I said, you probably gonna never hear a preacher say this again. I said, but a church is more about giving. It's more than just giving your money. Right. You know, I said, you can die and go on your way to hell with money in your pocket. Amen. You know, oh, I ain't never heard a preacher tell me like that, preacher. Oh. But it's more than that. It's more the work of God is more than just finances. Yeah. I mean, it takes finances to run the church of God and whatever it's not. But I shared that with him. You know, and I want to share that with you too this morning. It's good that we give, and the Bible instructs us to give. Yes. Give tenth of what the Lord blesses us with. But you know something? If we don't apply the whole word of God to our lives, we'll die with all the finances given to the work of God, and we'll die still, bust hell wide open. Wow. I didn't know that, preacher. That's correct. But anyway, I'm not trying to put a damper on the service. Our God is good.
Yes.
Our God, and that's what I'm going to be sharing this morning about the goodness of God and about His joy. And I mean, it surpasses all understanding. But I'm thankful that our God is faithful.
Yes.
It's faithful. This time, Sister Walls, Sister Sampson, is going to sing a special song as unto the Lord this morning.
Amen. Praise God. Get on in. We're going to sing praises, What I Do. And if you came here this morning to give God some praise, we want you to lift your hands, lift your voices, get on in with us. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise is what I do when I want to be close to you. I lift my hands in praise. Praise is who I am. I will praise you while I can. I'll bless you at all times. I vow to praise you in the good and the bad. I'll praise you, oh, whether happy or sad. I'll praise you in all that I go through, because praise is what I do. And I owe it all to you. Praise is what I do. Even when I'm going through, I've learned to worship you. Hallelujah. Though my circumstance doesn't even stand a chance, my praise outweighs the bad. I vow to you, and the good and the bad, I'll praise you, whether happy or sad. I'll praise you, I know that I go through, because praise is what I do. I vow to praise you in the good and the bad. I'll praise you, whether happy or sad. I'll praise you in all that I go through, because praise is I do. Come on, y'all stand up and sing with us. I vow to praise you. Lift your hands this morning and tell them how much you love them. Hallelujah. Yes. I'll praise you. stop now. Let's do it one more time.
I bow to praise you. Hallelujah. I do the good and the bad. I praise you. Whether happy or sad, I praise you. And all that I go through, I think of praise is what I do.
Thank you, Lord.
And I owe it all
to you. Lift up your hands and praise Him this morning. Let Him know how much you love Him. Hallelujah. Truly He's good.
Yes,
yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Don't stop. Hallelujah. That's what we came here to do this morning.
Hallelujah.
To lift up His holy name. To praise Him this morning. The joy of the Lord is our strength this morning. Come on now.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. You may be seated this morning. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The joy of the Lord is our strength this morning.
Amen.
That's what you came here to do this morning?
Yes,
to worship Him? And man, that's what I came here to do this morning.
Amen.
To get what the Lord has for my soul. Amen?
Amen.
And we're going to be reading a few verses of Scripture, but one verse of Scripture as a text this morning. Well, the book of Joshua chapter 24 and verse 15. Joshua 24 and verse 15. And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which were or which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me, in my house, we will serve the Lord. And this morning, we'd like to preach what the Lord wants this morning on a thought or message titled, "Is Your Choice." Is your choice. Brother Najim, could you please pray over the message and the messenger this morning, please? Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Appreciate that prayer.
Yes.
It's your choice. It's your choice, not chance, that determines your calling or your destiny. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 9, it says, "Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice." Also in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 32, It says, whether therefore you eat or drink, or whatsoever you do, or whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. This morning we are not a victim of circumstance. If we believe God, then He is our guide. Yeah. Not fate, not what goes on in all our circumstances. No. Not some kind of uncontrollable force. Paul says in Philippians chapter 4 and verse 9, we can rejoice always in the Lord. Yes, Lord. Do you believe that this morning?
Oh, yeah.
Man, I make a dead man shout. Well, praise God! In other words, the source of this joy comes from Almighty God. Doesn't come from the church, doesn't come from the pastor, but it comes from God, the one that you serve this morning. There's a difference between happiness and joy. Okay? Happiness depends on happenings or circumstances. When we go on vacation or we receive a large sum of money, that circumstance may bring about happiness for a little while. Hello? Joy, the Bible tells us, is part of the fruit of the Spirit. True joy comes from Almighty God. If we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior, but also as Lord of our lives, then we can expect this joy to fill our life. If we invite Christ into our lives, some accept Jesus as their Savior, but not Lord of their lives. They don't want to make a full or outright decision to follow Him completely. In Joshua chapter 24 and verse 15 we read, and if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your father served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Yes. What was Joshua saying here? For God's sake and your sake, make a decision.
Yes. Yes.
Make a decision. Yes. He's urging the people not to be indecisive. He's calling them to examine the facts and then choose. In 20th century language, or in this time that we're living in, He's urging men and women to be willing to repent of their sin and put their trust in Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. And Joshua, he here, was willing to be a model for that. He had done it for decades, serving the Lord. He could look back and say, the God of heaven has been faithful. And you know something, that serving God, I can honestly say that the God in heaven has been faithful to my life. Yeah. I can preach not by some type of manuscript, but I can preach with an assurance and a confidence in my heart that our God has never left us nor forsake us. I can preach with a surety in my heart that there's two things that I've never seen: the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. I can begin to preach with a surety that when we begin to apply the word of God to our lives, He will take care of us. He'll take care of us. Not the church. Say that. Not the church. You know, I never grew up in a church where I've seen people that come and ask a church to, to pay their bills or something like that. I didn't grow up like that. I remember my mom or my dad doing that. My daddy worked. My mom, she kind of stayed at home most of the time, and she took care of each one of us. But my dad, he went to work constantly every day, and he gave us an allowance, maybe a couple of dollars, put in our pockets. But you know something? When we got of age, he said, get a job. Get out there, boy, and get you a job. Begin to work. Don't be coming to me wanting an allowance. Make your own money. And as I begin to raise our children, our boys, I begin to Have them do jobs around our place, around the house, and I begin to write them a check in their name, a real check in their name, and put down in the memo, D-A-D-S, which means dad. Dads against deadbeat sons. They'll never forget it. Dads. And I give them that check, and they go to the bank and begin to cash it, and they begin to put their money in their pocket. But as they begin to get a little bit older, I begin to get them some rakes and some shovels, and I begin to say, hey, this is winter time. This is a fall time. Y'all going out there to make you some money. And I dropped them off on the street corner, and I gave them a little cell phone. I said, hey, look, call us back and just let us know where you're at and whatever. And they called me back about 10 minutes. Dad, we got our first job. They got their first job, but they had a big old yard, and it took them 3 days to do it, and they only charged the man $20. That's just a lesson in business. Joshua was saying here that the God of heaven had been faithful to him. He was saying that he had made his decision. For us, for me and my house, we're going to serve God. He's saying, what about you? What about you? Consider the options. What will bring you the greatest advantage? What will bring the greatest inner satisfaction and peace? What will give my life joy? Hello? Joy comes from God, who lives within each one of us if we know him as our personal savior, not from what's happening outside of our lives. If things are going on and circumstances are happening and if they're not for us, we don't have joy. We are unhappy. And if we don't get what we want, we will be unhappy. And we'll blame everyone else. It's that one's fault. It's that one's fault. He should have helped me. No. Think back. It's been shared that you are the sum total of the choices that you've made in the past. Of the choices. Your life is the sum total of all the choices. Well, preacher, no. Somebody, I shared that with somebody. They're like, well, you know, there were things happening in my life that I couldn't control. My father and my mother, they were abusive, and things happened in my life, and I couldn't control that. No, they may not control that, but they can control what goes on after that in the thoughts. They can stay there in the past and begin to blame everybody else, or they can continue to go forward and begin to say, hey, that may have happened, but I'm not going to let that stop me from doing what the Lord wants me to do. I'm not going to let the circumstances of my past, of my life that happened in the household that I grew up in, to begin to affect me right now today. But I'm going to believe Almighty God. I'm going to believe the Word of God. The Word of God is what I'm looking at this morning. Amen. Paul here, he was in prison there in the book of Philippians. When he made that statement, rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. He was in prison when he made that statement to the Philippians. If we understand Paul's circumstances, then we know without a shadow of a doubt that Paul was not happy. Hello? He's in prison, man. He was in prison and his future was uncertain. Yet, he says rejoice. And he said it twice. And again, I say, rejoice. He says, have joy. Joy is not just emotion. It's a choice. It's a choice. It's an attitude. An attitude of gratitude. An attitude towards life. The Apostle Paul was always looking to God, trusting him to lead and provide. I know God has me at this place, this church here, from all the choices that I've made in the past for him. Things begin, I prayed that prayer, and don't pray this prayer. God, take me through everything you got to go that I got to go through, because I don't want nobody coming to me. They don't understand. You don't understand, Pastor. You've never been in this same place. I have. I've been in a place where I was about to be evicted. I moved out before they evicted me. I've been in a place where my phone wasn't on. I've been in those places. I've been in the places that individuals have went through. And how did you get by, preacher? God. The Lord. The Lord saw fit of the messed up decisions that I made to begin to uphold me. That's right. That's why I could sit here or stand here this morning and say, hey, believe God. There was a woman early on in my Christian life, as I was a church member at a church, and the pastor, this woman came up to the pastor and she said, can I speak with you, pastor? And the pastor said, hey, Brother Wallace, come and talk to me. My wife is not here. Come and be with me with this woman. And so as I went with the pastor, the woman began to share about her situation. She said, you know, pastor, my electric bill is due and I can't afford to pay it and this and that and whatever. But I do have my tithe money, pastor. I want to pay tithe, but I want to ask you, should I pay my electric bill or my tithe? I was a young Christian. When the preacher, I was just looking, you know, and in my mind, I was like, what is he going to tell her? That's what I was like, what is he going to tell her? And he said, sister, all I'm going to say is put the Lord first and God will provide for you. So the woman, she paid her tithe. 2 days later, this woman came back running to the church. Hey, pastor, I got tithes. They forgave my electric bill. I can't believe it. I don't know why they did it, but I don't owe them a dime. You can say whatever you want. Oh, it just happened. You know, it's just a luck of the draw. No. When you put God first, he'll put you first. Amen. Paul was always looking to God, trusting him to lead and provide. You can choose to think always about your weakness, I put down this morning, about what you don't have or what you have done. Or you can just rejoice. Amen? Don't see the thorns among the roses, but begin to be thankful that the thorns are there among the roses. What are you looking at? Don't touch that rose bush. Those thorns are going to get you. Listen to the prophet Habakkuk. There in chapter 3, verse 17 through 19. He says, although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruit be in the vines, the labor of the olive shall fail, and the field shall yield no meat, the flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet, yet, I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength, and he will make my feet like hinds' feet, and he will make me to walk upon mine high places. Although the fig tree may not blossom, he said here, neither shall there be fruit in the vine, neither the labor of the olive oil shall fail, and the field shall have no meat. The flock shall be cut off, he said here, from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet I'm going to rejoice, God. I'm going to rejoice. May not have food in the cupboard. May not have gas in the car. Things may not seem, they may seem topsy-turvy. But you know something? I'm going to still rejoice. I'm going to still look to my God. I'm going to look to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. He's my sustenance. He's the one that continues to keep me. The words I will reveal Habakkuk's belief that he could choose his response, either to sink into despair or to rejoice in God's presence and power. You have a choice. The choice is yours. That's what I'm preaching on this morning. The choice is yours. His decision to rejoice wasn't a denial of hardship or sorrow. He saw that if the things were going on, his decision to rejoice wasn't because of denial or hardship. We all have times of sorrow and grief. Now, if your life is full of sorrow and grief, you need to come to the Savior. That's why I said, you need to come to the Savior. Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Serving God, your life should not be all sorrow and grief. Shouldn't be one circumstance after another. Shouldn't be, what's going on? Examine yourself. What are the choices? Thank you, sister. You want to say it out loud?
Amen.
That you're making.
That you're making.
What are the choices you're making?
Yes.
Sorrow can't knock us down.
Yes.
Okay? Our attitude towards life is very important.
Yes.
We can trust God in the good times,
yes,
and in the bad.
Yes.
You say, well, preacher, nothing seems like it happens in your life. Things happen in our lives.
Yes.
But you know something? Less things happen in our life because of the choices that I make.
Amen.
Everything that comes on, I got to make a choice.
Yes.
If something bad comes on, okay, what am I going to do? Sit down and examine the things that's going on in my life and examine what decisions that I have to make to take care of what's going on. Okay, I'm not exempt from problems. I'm not exempt from circumstances. But I do have to make a choice. A choice. The choice is ours every day to choose. To choose. To refuse to choose in itself is a choice. Mm-hmm. I'm going to let somebody else choose for me. No, don't do that. It's up to you. You know, someone can share something and now I know I'm in a leadership position and sometimes people look at me and say, well, pastor, he's doing this. Well, I'm going to do it too. But it's your choice. It's your choice to do that. Okay? Now, if I share something with someone, I'm not telling them to do anything because people are going to do what they want to do anyway. But it's your choice. And if you choose to do what the Word of God shares for you to do, whatever it entails after that, it was a choice that you made. If you say, well, it's a bad choice. No. If you choose God, it's never a bad choice. If you choose what the Word of God shares for you to do in your life, it's never a bad choice. Things may happen in your life that you say, well, I don't know if that was a good choice. But you know something? You trust in the Lord. It's going to work out together for your good.
Amen.
If you love God, that's what the Bible says. All things work together for good.
Yes.
To them that love the Lord.
Yes.
Got to put that in there now.
Yes.
Not that all things work together for good for anyone.
Yes.
But to them that love the Lord.
Yes.
You love them this morning?
Yes.
The choice is yours.
Yes.
This morning I want you to understand. Truly understand. That if you know Jesus this morning, you are truly blessed.
Amen.
You're truly blessed. If you woke up today with more health than illness, you're blessed.
Amen.
Even if you woke up this morning with illness in your life, you woke up this morning.
Amen.
If you attended church service without fear or harassment, arrest or torture or death, you're blessed.
Amen.
There's other countries that can't even do that. And even if you did, you're still blessed to have attended a church.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You have food in your refrigerator.
Hallelujah.
Clothes on your back.
A
roof over your. Well, I barely got a roof over my head, preacher. You know, they could kick me out any time now. You're blessed.
Amen.
You're blessed.
Amen.
If you can read, you're blessed.
Amen.
You're blessed.
Amen.
We take way too much things for granted. You and I are blessed in ways we may never fully comprehend on this side of eternity. You're blessed. Joy is a choice. It's a choice. You're blessed. And the last thing Paul tells us, we must commit ourselves to prayer. To prayer. Prayer. Personal time with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Jesus said, my yoke is easy. My burden is light. If your yoke is heavy, if your burdens are weighing you down, then you have the wrong yoke around your neck. Release these burdens this morning and cast them upon the Lord. Are you here this morning? He said, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for thee. He careth for thee. Only when you can entrust your worries to God can you experience true peace, true joy, his peace. Now, there's nothing wrong with having concern. We all have concerns. We all have concerns. It's when your concerns own you. When your worries own you. When all you think about is, I don't know how my, that's not how God created us to be. When we're always worried about where our next meal is going to come from, how we're going to pay our rent, how we're going to pay our phone bill, how we're going to do all these things. That's not God's will for your life. Okay? They move. The move from concerns and become worries, worries that impact your very being. You think about them all the time, your concerns, your worries. And that makes you under bondage. Puts you in bondage, chains. You know, I just had a picture in my mind of someone coming from the jail to the courtroom. Their hands are chained. How you know, preacher? Because I was in a courtroom with someone that he wanted me to support him. He ain't come out just walking all cool. No. His hands were chained and his ankles were chained. He had two people on each side of him. He wasn't going to hurt anyone. He wasn't going to take that chance. That's how some people's lives that say they know Jesus are like. They're walking around in chains all the time. Shh, 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 shh. I don't know what I'm going to do. This is happening and that's happening. But Jesus wants to break the chains and the fetters upon a man or woman's life. Amen?
Amen.
There was a man walking down a road with a sack of potatoes hanging on one shoulder. It was so heavy that this man was sweating. So as he was walking there, a man pulled over. He pulled over in a pickup truck and offered him a ride. He climbed into the passenger side, but he kept that pack of potatoes over his shoulder. After a while, the driver of the truck, he said, hey man, he said, you can put that sack of potato on the floor and relax. The man replied, no, sir. It's enough for you giving me a ride already. He said, I'll just keep this sack on my shoulder. And that's what some people do in serving the Lord. They're carrying a burden that the Lord never intended for them to carry. He picks them up, but they still got that sack of potatoes, that sack of sin around their shoulders. When we had a question when we were going to school, each one of us, when we had a question when we were going to school, we asked the teacher. When we were sick and helpless, we gave control over to the physician. When there is a legal problem that we could not solve, we gave our case to a lawyer. When in life we face difficulties, when we have burdens, we give those things unto the Lord. Okay? Things in our life. We give them to the Lord. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7. Yes. Casting all your care
yes.
upon him.
Yes.
For he careth for you.
Yes.
He cares for each one of us. There was a woman by the name of Corey Ten Boom. She says, worry does not empty tomorrow of its sorrow. It empties today of its strength. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Always looking, the Bible says, unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. He started us in this thing when we invited our heart, when we invited him into our hearts. We started this journey with Jesus. He was the author of our faith. You know something? As we journey with him daily, and when we close our eyes in death, he will be the finisher of our faith. Bible says, the prize goes to them that endure to the end. Endure. Well, I just want to, everything just be peachy all through my life, preacher. Goes to those that endure. Life is a lot of endurance. Things happen in our lives, and we got to think the right way, act the right way, do the right things. But we can't do it. Jesus said, without me, you can do nothing. Can't do it without Jesus. And when I say we can't do it without Jesus, I am not saying we can't do it without church. Yeah. What if they took the church out the way? Okay? That happened last year when we couldn't even come to, and get together. And some of that, well, you know, we don't have church. Well, and they held up in their homes and whatever, and maybe read the Bible once in a while, but begin to think, is this the end? Is this the end? Was you like that preacher? No. We couldn't meet all together, but you know something? I ain't stopped preaching. I came to this church, set up my phone just like it's set up right here, and begin to preach. I'm going to broadcast. Amen. I'm going to broadcast the word of God. I'm not going to just sit in my house and begin to fiddle my thumbs or begin to hide in a corner and begin to open up the Bible once in a while and say, Lord, I hope that you come and get me. Oh, no. We all have something to do for him. We all have something to offer to Jesus Christ. The Father offered his son. Let me call it calm down. He offered his son on the cross for us. I'm going to ask you a question this morning. What are you offering to him? What are you offering to Jesus Christ? Do you even bring an offering to him? The only thing he's asking us for is to give him your life. Jesus was in the Garden of Gethsemane. He told the Father, he said, Father, if it be thy will, let this cup pass from me. He may have been fully God, but he was fully man at the same time. He said, if it be your will, Lord, let this cup pass from me. He said, but no. He said, not my will. But let your will, let thine be done. Let your will be done. If you do those things that are easy in life, your life is going to be hard. But if you do those things which are hard in life, your life is going to be easy. Everybody's looking for the easy route. And they wonder why their life is so hard. But if you do those things that are hard to do, those things that you know to do that, my flesh, then your life would be easy. Because you would have begun to do those things that you know to do that's correct. I woke up this morning, I'm going to close. I woke up this morning with thinking the exact words in my mind. The exact words that were in my mind were sharing some light. It's up to you. It's your choice. So I woke up and I said, Sister Walls, the Lord's telling me, it's my choice. It's up to you. And I told her, I said, it's up to me to get out this bed and go out there and walk 2 miles. It's up to me. I can just sit here and lay in the bed and under the covers is so good. That pillow or whatever it is not. If I do those things which are hard, my life is gonna be easy. It's gonna be easy. But you got to do those things that are challenging in your life. Challenging. Don't try to get over trying to do the easy stuff. Because then your life's going to be hard. Because why is my life so hard? Because you're always looking for the easy route. Yeah. Oh, preacher, is this the Bible? Oh, this is psychology. The Bible is Jesus. He dealt with people. And he said he knew what was in man. you know, in living my life, I know in, through my life, in the past, I was always looking for the easy route. And I was couldn't understand, why is everything so hard? But once I started challenging myself, I'm going to go to church more often. I'm going to read my Bible more often. I'm going to do this. Once I started challenging myself, holding myself accountable instead of going the easy route. Once I started challenging myself, things begin to get a little bit easy. Wow, what's going on? I don't understand why is this happening. Because I was challenging myself to do those things that my flesh did not want to do. Are you here this morning? I know you don't want to hear this, but I'm telling you the truth. There was a native Christian elder. He described, and this is the last time I say, he described life's struggle with a young man with this truth. He said, it feels like there are two dogs fighting inside of me. The young man asked, which dog wins? And the older man, he replied, whichever one I feed. Are you feeding life's struggles? Are you feeding your concerns and turning them into worries and burdens? Or are you rejoicing and choosing joy? It's your choice. Your life can start to turn around. Your life can turn around. Today, this morning, by making the correct choice. And what choice is that? If it's hard, it's the right choice. If it's hard to you, that's the right choice. Take that choice. But if it's easy, don't go down that route. Because if you do those things that are easy, your life is going to be hard. The song says, and they're not going to sing it, no. They don't have it in anywhere. It says, oh, they may have it. The song says, give it all to Jesus. And he'll turn your sorrows into joy. Choose this morning. You are blessed and are called to be a blessing. Each one of us. He said, his yoke is easy and my burden is light. Go to him in prayer and he will turn your sorrows. He will turn your burdens. He will turn your whole life into joy. Let's all bow our heads. Close our eyes this morning as we close this service in prayer. Father, help me to yield all of who I am. All of me. Body, soul, and spirit to your transforming love. Break me, Lord, when I need to be broken. And strengthen me, Lord, when I need strength. You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. The great I am. The Alpha and Omega. The beginning and the end. One that continues to walk through the 7 golden candlesticks. Father, as your child, I choose this morning your ways. Not my own way, but your way. I lay my burdens down and I choose joy and life. It's your choice this morning. Heavenly Father, help those that are here to make the correct decision as they look to you, Lord. Not to anyone else, but to you. Help them to make the correct decisions this morning. I ask. The altars are open this morning. You desire prayer. Come forward. Kneel at this altar this morning. This altar of surrender. This altar of sacrifice. This is the altar that the Lord has called you to come. Come, he says. Come, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Come unto me. And I friends, come share this morning. God bless you. Is our prayer this morning.
Here I am, here I stand, Lord, my life is in your hands, Lord, I'm longing to see your desire revealed. Myself away. Hallelujah. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Yes. I give myself away so you can use me, take my heart, take my life as a living sacrifice. All my dreams, all my plans, Lord, I give myself away. Hallelujah, Lord. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Yeah. I give myself away so you can use me. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. Oh, my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. Oh, my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Let's all stand. Let's all stand.
Here I am to worship.
This is a Samson.
Here I am to bow.
here I am to say that He's our God. We're all together. Thank you, Jesus. Lovely. Worthy. Thank you, Jesus. All together. Wonderful. All right, no music. Come on, sing.
Here I
can we hear you?
Yeah,
I'm gonna. Come on.
Here I am to
bow down to Him.
Here I am
to say that He's our God. You're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy. Hallelujah. Worthy. Altogether wonderful. Wonder. I want everything. Everything. Let's sing it as unto Him. One more time. Here I am to worship. Let's lift up our hands this morning. Worship Him. Praise His holy name. Hallelujah. Lord, You are our God this morning, God. God, every single day, God. Regardless of what happens. Regardless, Lord, of the decisions. Help me, God, to choose You, to choose life each and every day. Thank You, Jesus. Let's all bow our heads this morning. Hallelujah. Let's all bow our heads this morning as we close the service in prayer this morning. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You for meeting with us this morning, Lord. Help us, Lord, to make the right choice, because the choice is Yours this morning. Brother Josh, could you please close in prayer?
Our loving Father, we thank You for Your Spirit who's truly here this morning. God, we thank You for the love that You give us to make the right choice in life. And God, we appreciate the love that's there, that when we do make the wrong choice, that You're always willing and able to forgive each and every one
of us.
But God, as we come to this service, and we come to the portion of the service where we're getting ready to go our separate ways, God, we just ask that we would look at our life and examine it. And God, we would ask the questions, are we really making the right choices in our lives? And if not, why not? God, we just ask that You would fill us with the Holy Spirit. God, we just ask that You would help us to walk every day uprightly in You. And God, we ask every day that You would help us to make the right choices, to make the hard choices first so we can live an easy life. And to make those things right with You so that we can have that peace and that joy and not walk every day in misery. God, watch over each and every one of us and keep us safe. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Go with the Lord, He will go with you. Continue to look to Jesus, because the choice is Yours. God bless you.